will go up here. We'll be in Val's row.
I don't want to be in the way of this camera.
Oh, you have a... Oh, this is your pledge, I think, probably. Well, he said you started coming at the wrong time, but I think probably...
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join me in the words of the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God,
you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtues and sacrament, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting.
Please be seated. Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb. And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen. Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from? I said to him, Sir, you are the one that knows. And he said to me, These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God, and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more, thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read Psalm 34 responsively from the verse. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who trust in him.
Fear the Lord, you that are his saints, for those who fear him lack nothing.
The young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
The Lord ransoms the life of his servants, and none will be punished who trust in him.
The second lesson is a reading from John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, but we will be as not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand as you are. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. After he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
so happy to see you all here on this All Saints Day, and not the least of which because it indicates that you survived Halloween. So congratulations. For Linda and I, this was a first Halloween in a new neighborhood, and it was a wonderful way to get to meet neighbors and others who live nearby. Although I will admit to one challenge, we grossly underestimated the demand for candy. We were done in about 30 minutes. And our neighbors kept going for hours, so a lesson learned. But primarily, we are grateful because it is the precursor to this day, to All Saints Day, which is a big deal in the church, because today we remember all those saints who have gone before us. We recall our own baptisms as fledglings. And when we are so blessed, we welcome the newly baptized into the body of Christ. And what's more, today, Jesus gives us a primer on the saintly qualities of life. But first, perhaps we need to be reminded of who or what the saints are. I suspect many of our minds turn to those who have been canonized by the Catholic Church as saints with a capital S. These are people whose lives have been scrutinized by the Church and who have had verifiable miracles performed in their name. But then, there are the saints with a small S. These are the holy ones who have gone through the ordeal that is life without having lost their way. Those who have been faithful stewards of their baptismal vows and covenant, and who have remained rooted or connected to Jesus Christ. This rootedness and or connectedness with Christ begins with our baptism, when we are grafted into the vine that is Jesus Christ, and it continues throughout our life as we mature into attentive stewards of our roots and grow more fully into the company of saints that are the body of Christ and residents of the kingdom of heaven. But just what are the fruits of being grafted into the vine that is the body of Christ? The Beatitudes we have just heard from this Sermon on the Mount are the primer on the saintly qualities of life I referenced earlier. These may not be the fruits that you were anticipating or hoped for. These fruits are not replete with praise and honor for our efforts. As you may recall from our song and from the lesson of the Revelation to John, praise and honor are reserved for God alone. However, what is afforded us are blessings, that is, happiness and satisfaction in this life and the kingdom of heaven to come, if we are able to accept a rootedness that foregoes honor and praise, and accept with equanimity the modest blessings that God provides the poor in spirit, those who mourn, those who meek, the meek, those who hunger, the merciful, the pure in heart, the peacemakers, and those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake. The past 9 months have given us a glimpse of all these aspects of life as holy ones. The past 9 months have been challenging and caused many to question the fairness of life. But perhaps they've also revealed modest blessings as well, as we have adapted to a new manner of living. But we're not there yet. We're not done. There are miles and months to go. And the Beatitudes, which is the first teaching that Jesus offers the disciples after he has called them to follow him, This he is telling them and us, within earshot of the crowds, just what we can look forward to as his followers. It isn't always a life of ease. It isn't a life without discord. But if we remain rooted and connected in the body of Christ and in these blessings, it is a life of sufficiency and contentedness, here and forever in the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, we do have cause to rejoice and be glad, for our reward in heaven is great, if we but are faithful stewards of our baptismal covenants and the blessings we share in this life and in the months to come. Please stand as you're ready. Through the Paschal mystery, dear friends, we are buried with Christ by baptism into his death and raised with him in newness of life. I call upon you, therefore, to renew the solemn promises and vows of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and all his works, and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil and renew your commitment to Jesus Christ?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father? Christ, the Son of God.
I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of the Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he suffered on the cross of God, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
You believe in God, the Holy Spirit.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will with God's help.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by his grace, in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. We pray for those in harm's way, especially Michael, Ian, John, Scott, David, and Russell, and all essential workers. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation, especially Isabel, Carol, Kay, Al, Bob, Dick, Elmer, Letty, Carol, Dennis, Gail, Jack, John, Marilyn, Lindsay, Lillian, Layla, Dee Dee, Dixie, Evelyn, Lee, Jean, Karen, Lexi, Sandra, Nancy, Bill, Steve, Donna, and Mark. We commend to your mercy all who have died this past year. Lois Shelley, Jean Schaefer, Ann Latham, John Shelley, Joanne Newman, Marion Boyle, Sherman Hawley III, Betsy Bailey, Peter Hamburg, Jack Griffin. And we remember Barbara Shirk and Charles Domansky, for whom the flowers are given, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Kneeling as you are able, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you.
Peace. I know we all look forward to the time and the day when we can return to our more wholesome exchange of peace, something we have to look forward to. Well, please be seated. I'd like to share with you a few announcements of what's going on this week and in the weeks to come. Today, the 1st of November, is the last day in which to order Christmas wreaths and greens. And the forms for those are in the narthex on one of the tables. So if you've not had the chance and are doing some last-minute shopping, now's an opportunity before you leave today. Also, in the narthex waiting for you on your way out, there are the stewardship packets. Yes, it is that time of year again, folks. And they will be sitting out on the tables so you can identify yours and pick it up and take it home with you on your way out today. There are still 13 days remaining, counting today, for St. Michael's Medal nominations to be submitted. If you've not had the opportunity to give thought to that, you still have just under 2 weeks left to do that, so please do. And be in touch with the office, the church office, if you need any help or have any questions. And back to Christmas again. The Christmas tree sale is continuing, and there will be an opportunity to go to the Walker's Tree Farm next Saturday and Sunday, the 7th and 8th. And the following Saturday and Sunday, which I guess is the 14th and the 15th, to, if you want to personally select your tree and tag it there, and then it will be delivered miraculously here for you to pick up at church here on December 5th, Saturday, December 5th. And I think between 9 and 5, is it? 9 and 3. Thank you, Barb. And the hours for going to the farm are actually 12 to 5 in the next 2 weekends. So, yes, time is flying by, so please, act now. and stay tuned, too, unfortunately, we had to postpone the Common Grounds program for today. But stay tuned, that and others are still in the wings, and they will be announced via the Friday email and other opportunities. So stay tuned for those to come. And sir, I don't know if you have anything you would add to that, or okay? Good enough. Thank you. And we actually today, and not for today only, but we actually for today for our youth, so I'll speak to the camera for those who are home, we actually have an opportunity to share in an All Saints specific Sunday school lesson that's been provided to us by Father Jeff Bump and the parishioners at St. Timothy's Parishburg. And so there is in the Friday email letter, there is a link that'll take you to Vimeo, which is a free app that you can download and watch it at your discretion on your computer or tablet or phone at home. And there also is attached to that the activities pack. So I hope we'll take advantage of that today and perhaps in the week to come as time permits. And last but not least, we also have our weekly Wednesday evening confine service at 6 p.m. And that you're able to access that through the church website. We have a wonderful cadre of regulars who participate and look forward to it as a highlight of each week. And I invite you to come and join us for this time. It's about 30 minutes long. And much of that time includes just visiting, catching up with one another, those we haven't seen for a while. So I hope you'll avail yourself of that opportunity as well. Are there other announcements for the good of the order? Then, who am I and who are my people that we are able to make this free will offering? For all things come from you, O Lord, and of your own have we given you. please stand if you're ready. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. For in the multitude of your saints, you have surrounded us with a great cloud of witnesses, that we might rejoice in their fellowship and run with endurance the race that is set before us, and together with them receive the crown of glory that never fades away. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever say this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father,
we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy kingdom, and power, and glory, forever.
We bring this bread to share in the body of Christ.
We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread.
The gifts of God for the people of God. For those joining us from home or those who are unable to receive communion this day, I invite you now to be praying prayer for spiritual communion as provided in your bulletin. As a reminder, as I sanitize my hands yet again, we will come in single file, maintaining social distance, beginning with the front rows, working backwards. Please, in the aisle, maintain your distance from others who are not part of your family. And you may stop at the hand sanitizer here at the head of the nave and get some lotion for your hands. And then come forward and I will deposit a host into your hand. I ask that you, after you receive the host, that you step aside, either right or left, depending on which side of the church you're sitting on, consume your wafer, and then return to your seat back by the outside aisles, if you will. And hopefully that's clear as mud. I invite you to come forward at this time if you would care to receive.
Thank you.
feet. We thank you for gathering us, your people. We call for remembrance the many times we have been fed at your table, and we lament our distance now. Be present, Lord Jesus, as you were present with your disciples. Be known to us in the breaking of bread. May your Holy Spirit sustain us and all your church until we can gather together again. We ask this for the sake of your love. Amen.
The peace of the Lord, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Now please remain seated for the postscript.
In peace, to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.